cluster analysis a type of factor analysis?
See, let me explain one thing here. In statistics, all the tools are known as statistical techniques only, whether it's correlation regression or whether it's cluster analysis or factor analysis. See, basically both are helping us to form a group of, you know, objects. In case of cluster analysis, we can form the group of objects in terms of respondents. In case of factor analysis, we can form group of variables. So basically both are helpful to form a group. That is why it is known as factor analysis. But see, as I told you, statistician has given different names, Q and R, to differentiate these two techniques. But objective is more or less same here. Okay, Varsha. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ha. Okay.
Ma'am, actually, independent variables, there must be multicollinearity, ma'am, to conduct factor analysis.
Yes. See, in factor analysis, all the variables should be independent. That means, see, like if I talk about correlation, correlation is what? Association between two variables. So if we have association between two variables, then only we will be able to find out the factor loadings. And basically factor analysis works on association value only. So there should be multicollinearity. Yes.
Can we check reliability, ma'am?
See, Varsha, actually you are not audible. Can you be little bit louder?
Ma'am, I am Vaishnavi, ma'am.
Okay, Vaishnavi. Can you be little bit louder? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, you told in CFA we can check reliability.
Mm-hmm. Yes, true.
Similarly, in EFA can't we check, ma'am? Only after doing CFA can we check reliability.
Yes, see, in case of factor analysis, we can check one thing, whether the app technique which we are using is suitable on collected data or not. But for further use, for further research work, if we want to use those factors, like as I told you, for satisfaction, few factors have been extracted. Let's say three factors have been extracted. But if we have, you know, collected data of the respondents who are from SBI Bank, if we want to check whether these three factors are actually, you know, leads satisfaction towards banking sector or not. So if you want to use same factors for further research work, then we have to perform confirmatory factor analysis. Exploratory factor analysis use is very limited. See, once we get the factors, we have to stop here. We cannot use those factors further. For further research work, like for one bank we have extracted three factors, that doesn't mean for all the banks we will get the same factors which leads satisfaction. Okay, so if we want to check, you know, whole banking sector, whether satisfaction depends on which factors, so whether extracted factors actually represents the satisfaction or not, that we can identify using confirmatory factor analysis only.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Hello. Cluster analysis.
Give me answer, ma'am. Yes. Continue. Cluster analysis.
Ma'am, so cluster analysis is a separate statistical technique and it is not related to factor analysis, ma'am.
Yes, it's separate. See, row wise and column wise, row and column. If you can simply understand, when we prepare the Excel sheet, row wise we prepare the responses like first respondent, second respondent, whatever they have responded, that we enter row wise. But if I talk about column wise values, so that is about the variables. That is about the variables. So basically factor analysis works on the variables. It helps us to reduce the number of variables. That means columns. And cluster analysis helps us to reduce the number of rows. Number of row. Or rather than using reduction word, we can use classification in terms of cluster analysis. It helps us to classify the rows into different groups. So these way both the methods are very different. Purpose is same. It forms, you know, group, but group of variables and group of respondents, these two things are different. Okay.
Ma'am, one more thing. You
yes.
were explaining the split test, no, ma'am?
Which test?
Split test, ma'am, to identify how many models that are there in first cluster, how many models are there in second cluster.
Yes.
I couldn't understand.
Okay.
Later, can you tell in WhatsApp the steps, ma'am? How did you fastly did the split test?
No problem. I can explain it currently, not an issue. See how it works. So lastly, we will get the rotated component matrix. When we perform the factor analysis, we will get rotated component matrix. In rotated component matrix, what we have to do is row wise, we have to check the values, highest value. We need to identify highest value.
I'm asking about cluster analysis, ma'am.
Okay, you are asking question related to clusters. So in case of clusters, how to identify participants under each cluster? That is your question.
You did some split test.
Okay, split test. Yes. It is not test. Split test is not test. But see, in cluster analysis, suppose we have got two clusters. Then have to check which particular respondent fall under which particular cluster. So suppose first respondent is a part of first cluster or second cluster, how to identify that? For that, split file helps us to split files into two groups.
Yes, ma'am. I didn't know how to do that split files only.
Oh, so steps you are asking for?
Steps, ma'am. Later, okay, you can tell, ma'am. No problem.
Okay, for that I need to open SPSS. So we'll discuss it. We'll give you answer on WhatsApp group.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Next question.
Good evening, ma'am.
Hello. Next question, please. Yes, Namrata, you can continue. Yes. Okay, Varsha.
Yeah, ma'am, Varsha here. Ma'am, I have a confusion between hierarchical and K means. Means when to use, exactly when to use hierarchical and when to use K means. Is there any rule?
See, let me explain what is the difference. In simple terms, if I talk about k-means, so k-means is what? It divides the data into different groups randomly. Do you understand this word? Randomly. That means no purpose, nothing, rule or no system behind it. But if I talk about hierarchical clustering, it uses hierarchy. Hierarchy, that means what? Simple example I have explained in PPT as well. If I talk about the position in any company, so manager's view, then clerk's view, what pions think about the same object, that way it clubs the groups according to their position in company. So if I have collected 150 samples, or see minimum suppose say 100 samples, out of 100 few managers were there, few CEOs were there, and few pions were there or clerks were there, then it separately form a group of managers. It forms group of CEO on the basis of their responses. That way it forms a group. On the basis of hierarchy, we will get the groups. So when objective is to form groups of hierarchy, priority wise, if we want to prepare a group, then we can go for hierarchical clustering. But randomly, if we want few groups, that example I have discussed in car models. So different car models are there, just want to know which models are having same features, just to know that thing. So that is random clustering. So that is called k-means clustering. That is the basic difference between these two. Random clustering and hierarchical clustering. Random word suggests that randomly it will form the group, and hierarchical suggests priority wise it will form the group. That is the basic difference between these two.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Next question.
Good evening, ma'am. I'm Nitin. I just would like to know, the first day when we are just doing those factor analysis, you said that all variables should be scaled based variable there. So can we do it using some nominal as well as ordinal, or everything should be in a scale based ratio or interval in factor or cluster analysis?
In case of factor analysis, you must have to collect data in terms of scale, that means interval or ratio kind of data you require to perform factor analysis.
Even it for cluster analysis also, it should be scale based.
Scale data, yes, that means interval or ratio.
And both.
In short,
okay, both the factor as well as cluster analysis.
Have you retest? For categorical data, we have very limited test in statistics. So, like chi-square is there. So, if ordinal if ordinal or nominal type of data are there, then you have to go for chi-square only.
Okay, yesterday when we were doing the k-means and then hierarchical cluster analysis, when we done the k-mean and when you started the hierarchical, you actually input data again. So does it require, because then you get two files of output, does it mean that?
Can you repeat the question?
For the hierarchical cluster analysis, you again enter the data. You again enter the data from the Excel. How? Yes. What could be the reason? Yeah.
Yes, yes. See, reason behind that is I've clicked on cluster membership. You click on cluster membership.
Yeah.
One last column will be formed.
Yeah.
That is.
And the second thing is that if you just look at this type of analysis, the confirmatory factor analysis, that is not possible in SPSS.
Yes. For that, you require AMOS.
AMOS.
Okay. AMOS is again statistical software which will give you whole model.
Okay.
On factors extracted. It will use factors extracted only, but gives you exact value with validity and reliability test answer.
Okay. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yes, next question. Okay, here in chat box, one question is there. How do we use the cluster membership in discriminant analysis? So are you talking about particular or separate test, which is known as discriminant analysis? Or are you talking about the cluster and, discrimination in cluster analysis? Both the things are different. Can you mention that in chat box? Cluster membership helps us to differentiate or identify each participants under different clusters. But if you are talking about discriminant analysis, that is something different. Okay, cluster based. So in case of cluster analysis, cluster membership helps us to discriminate. Discriminant analysis is what? How to differentiate the groups. If two clusters have been formed, then each participant is under each cluster, which cluster, that we can identify using cluster membership. Once we get that last column in our data sheet, then we can use split file option in SPSS, which helps us to check all values together. That means the participants under first cluster, that you can check at the same time in a sequence, that is called split file. So discrimination is what? First number, you can check how many participants are there under the first cluster and how many participants are under second cluster in a sequence. Random basis, you will not get answer in random basis. 1, 2, 1, 2. If you have answer in that way, 1, 2, 1, 2 or 2, 2, 1, then it would be difficult to analyze or interpret data. But if you will use split file, all the options will appear together. All participants which are part of cluster one will appear together. So it would be easier for the searcher to interpret that data. That is the use of cluster membership and split file. If you don't want to use that split file option, you can independently or manually check which participant is a part of which cluster, and then you can write the interpretation. But a software helps us to put all the values together, put all the values which are part of first cluster or which are part of second cluster, it helps us to put it together. So that is why I've used a split file. But if you are not comfortable with software, you can do it manually as well. Individually, you have to check each row, and on the basis of that, you can write the interpretation. So today we'll talk about cluster analysis and factor analysis. For discriminant analysis, you need to first understand what is the purpose of the test, what kind of data require, in which situation we can go for discriminant analysis. So that is something different. So if you have any queries regarding factor analysis and cluster analysis, please ask me. Discriminant is a separate technique. And to understand that, again, we need to discuss for 2 hours. Yes, next question.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, like if I'm having less than 10 factors, 10 variables.
Yes.
So I can just go for SEM like that, no, ma'am?
Yes, you can go for factor analysis. See, basic requirement for factor analysis is 3 variables. If you have checked the PPT,
should we not have minimum 10 variables to go for?
No, minimum 3 to 5 variables you require. 3 to 5 is there in book, or you can check any website as well. See, there is no thumb rule, but again, how it works, factor analysis. How it works, so it forms or it clubs minimum 3 variables and maximum 5 variables. That is the general rule, we can say, not thumb rule, but general rule, how it forms the factors, how it clubs the variables and how it forms the factors. So it clubs 3 to 5 variables. So minimum we require 3 variables to perform factor analysis, to form one particular factor. Minimum we require 3 variables. So remember this thing. Yes, many people are having this issue. Minimum variable should be how many? So minimum variables should be 3 in case of factor analysis.
Okay. Ma'am, if I don't want to do factor analysis and I can, I'm having variables like 4 or 5. Can I go for SEM straightly, ma'am?
You can. Yes. See. Suppose same example, if I continue with same example, if you want to check satisfaction towards banking sector. So what is the difference between factor and variable? Variable is a very small thing. Well, if I talk about factors, it includes so many things, so many objects, or we can say so many parameters. Parameters, that means what? Simple, you can directly ask question, are you satisfied with the services provided by the bank or not? That question also gives you answer. And if you will consider Likert scale, you know, strongly disagree to agree, that scale, that also that will give you answer. But directly asking whether you are satisfied or not will give you answer in terms of single value. These many percent or these much respondents were satisfied. While if you are using factor analysis, if you are using factors, that will give you much more idea about the satisfaction. You will be able to describe about the satisfaction in a good manner. If you are doing research, then you need to write everything in detail. So if you are doing in-depth study, you should consider factors rather than using variables. So if only 5 variables are there, and 5 factors are there. Let me explain difference again. If 5 variables are there and 5 factors are there related to the satisfaction, 5 factors, you should go for 5 factors, which helps you explain more about the satisfaction. Are you getting my point?
Ma'am, 5 factors you are saying.
See, let me repeat again. Simple way. See, suppose on satisfaction you have asked 5 questions. That means you have 5 variables on satisfaction. And I have asked 25 questions on satisfaction. And on the basis of factor analysis, I have 5 factors. As a result, I have 5 factors which explain about the satisfaction level. And you have 5 variables which says about the satisfaction level. So I can see. You know, are you getting my point? What is the difference between variables and factors? Why to go for factors? It will help you in in-depth study regarding satisfaction level. If you are using variables, that will give you brief idea about the satisfaction word or satisfaction, particular satisfaction, you know, simple. It's very simple. I think I don't have much more explanation about it. Five variables and five factors are there. Five factors includes 25 variables, while five variables are five variables only. So rather than using five variables, you should go for five factors, which will help you to explain about the satisfaction level in detail. Okay.
Ma'am, if my variables are a mix of mediating and moderating variables, ma'am, then those cannot be clubbed, no, ma'am. Some mediating and moderating variables cannot be related to independent variables. Can I go for factor analysis?
See, it is not necessary every time to go for factor analysis. If you have 4 to 5 objectives in your research work, so satisfaction I'll continue with same example. If satisfaction is not your primary objective, you want to check preference as well. So if you have 4 to 5 objectives and you have to give priority to each and every objectives same, then it's not necessary to go for factor analysis. But if you are, your objective is only to know about the satisfaction, then you have to do in-depth study about satisfaction. Are you getting my point? What is the difference in which situation?
Yes. If you have your mediating and moderating variables, ma'am,
okay,
other than independent and dependent variables, can we go for factor analysis?
See, that is what I am telling you. Variable, see, factor analysis is applicable on any numerical values. But you have to check the situation as well as objective or purpose of the study. Hello. Purpose is what? That you need to check, whatever variable is there. See, any number, you can apply factor analysis on any number. But what is your objective? Do you want to form factors or not? That you have to check. Do you want to priority to these objective in your research work or not? Situation is also important, objective is also important. If you don't want to form factors, then why to go for factor analysis? If your objective is to reduce variables and prepare a concrete result on the basis of factors, then only you have to go for factor analysis.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. One more question here is difference between factors and variables. Okay. Simple example. Satisfaction. Again, we'll continue with same example. So variables should be like ambience of the bank, or we can say the service, like ATM service, ATM working regular basis or not. Then the staff is giving answers every time or not. These kind of questions, if you have asking. Your work factors. So if you can just remember that satisfaction towards bank then includes the all variables related to the ambience of the bank, whether it's located in all the areas, or whether the proper staff is there or not. So simple example, factors, we can say technology use in bank. And if you have asked questions related to technology in your questionnaire, 4 to 5 questions are there. ATM working properly, strongly disagree to strongly agree. Then passbook machine is working properly, strongly disagree to agree. These are variables. And technology used in banking, that is your factor. Okay. Have you got your answer, Bhavika? Difference between factors and variables. Variables are questions asked in questionnaire, and factors are group of variables. So if you have asked 4 to 5 questions related to technology, then technology is the factor, while those 5 questions are called variables. As I have already explained, ATM machine working properly, strongly disagree to agree. Second question is on passbook printing machine working properly. Strongly disagree to agree. These are variables. I'm talking about variables. Then third technology, cash machine working properly. Strongly disagree to agree. So these are your variables. And technology. Technology is your factor. It's a group of variables. Yes, very good. Okay. Next question. Question.
Ma'am.
Yes.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Actually, my doubt is not related to factor analysis or cluster analysis. It's a general doubt.
Yes.
You could answer now or later. Shall I ask, ma'am? Because I'm in the preliminary stage of research.
Okay.
Can I ask on doubt, ma'am?
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, in order to, I'm having certain variables. In order to find the impact of independent variable on dependent variable and through some mediating and moderating variables, ma'am.
Okay.
Can you tell me what test should I go for?
See, you have to check your objectives first. In your research work, are you doing PhD or writing research paper?
Ma'am, I have just submitted my review paper and I am stepping into research work, ma'am.
Okay. First, you have to check your objectives and then you can decide
my
the test.
My objective is my objective is to analyze the impact of intellectual capital and financial performance of companies, ma'am.
Okay, so you can go for any bivariate test. If your objective is to check impact, then you can go for any bivariate test, yes. This cluster analysis and factor analysis are multivariate test.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. These are multivariate tests.
Bivariate is related to two variables, no, ma'am?
Yes, two variables.
But I have more than two variables, ma'am, so only I have.
Yeah, that's true. But then see, if you want to check impact, then you can check impact of one variable on other only. So what you can do is, if one variable, to collect the data related to one variable, if you have asked so many questions, then you can consider the average of those questions.
What I'm saying is, to find the impact of variable is only my study, but I have one mediating and one moderating variable. So four variables are there in my study. So should I go for bivariate or multivariate analysis?
And then individually you have to perform the bivariate test. Four variables are there, so you cannot go for simultaneous analysis. You have to go one by one, individually or independently, you have to apply the bivariate test. Are you getting my point? If four variables are there, simultaneously you cannot check the impact of all four variables. One by one, you have to check the impact.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, next. Okay, let me show you how to split the file on Excel sheet. Somebody was having question related to that. We have time, so let me show you how to perform that. Just wait for a few minutes. I'm opening SPSS file. Thank you. File is opening. Till the time, if you have any queries, you can continue with same. Okay, let me see.
Yes.
Let me show you how to perform the test. Split test. It's not test. It just helps us to put the same kind of data together. See here. This shows the cluster membership. Suppose this shows the cluster membership. Go to the data. Go to the split file. See, if you want to note down these points, you can note down. Somebody was having this question. Have to use this option in SPSS split file. Click on split file. This option will appear. Organize our output by group. See, total I have entered 4 values. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you can see here, 1 is there, 2 is there, 4 is there. Now see the difference. Now see the difference. See, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Have you got my point? So this helps us to put the same responses together. So what was the data? 1, 2, 4. Now here you can see all files or all the responses which is having answer 1 add together, then 2, 3, 4, this way. Now you can collect the information regarding these and you can interpret the data, cluster membership. I'm talking about cluster membership. In case of cluster membership, last column will be formed if you will click on the save membership. And that will give you idea about each participant under each cluster. Now, if you will use this split file, it will help you to put all the responses which are part of one particular cluster. And then you can interpret it easily. If you have data like this, 1, you can see here, 2, 4, this kind of data. So it would be difficult for you to check each variable or each response, not variable, but each response and each cluster combination of that. So one is a part of one, second is a part of first cluster, third response or third respondent is a part of second cluster. So manually you have to check one is where, two is where, or which response or respondent is a part of which particular cluster. But if you will see here, it would be easier for any researcher to write the interpretation on the basis of this. These three respondents are a part of first cluster. These respondents are part of second cluster. So it would become easier for any researcher to write the interpretation. That is why I have used this split file option here in SPSS. Otherwise, if you have got cluster membership like this, you can manually check and write down the interpretation. It's not necessary to perform this step. Okay. Yes. Now, next question. Yes, next question.
Madam, in a case of cluster analysis, how many variables we can have to reduce it?
Okay, see, in case of cluster analysis, variables are not important. In case of cluster analysis, respondents are important, sample size is important.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, next question. See, if you will check different books, different websites, it will be very confusing. Everything is not clear. So I have tried to put it in a clear manner and simple manner in my PPT. So still you have a chance. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Otherwise, see, all the options are available nowadays. But see, this way I can help you. So still you have a time. If you have any queries, ask me right now. No queries, no questions. Nobody is having any question. Hello. Nobody is having any question. We'll wait for next 5 minutes, otherwise we'll wind up the session. If you have queries, please ask me.
One question, maybe last from my side.
No,
that the cluster membership, that number has to be entered there when we do that save option there in SPSS.
Yes. Repeat the question.
That cluster membership, that yes. Option which is there in SPSS, that we need to enter there so to get output.
Yes, that is required. In case of K-means, you can enter that option while performing this first time.
Yeah.
But in case of hierarchical clustering, you can select that option while you rerun the process. First time, you cannot select that option. Because first, you need to mention number of clusters at that time. That is why.
Okay, the first process we don't have to merge, just two mentions, suppose two clusters, that's fine. But when second iteration is, repeat
yes,
process.
In case of hierarchical clustering, it's a stepwise clustering and you have to do it stepwise only. In the first, at the first time, you cannot enter, you cannot select each and every option.
Okay.
No more questions. I'm actually surprised. Okay, some tips on do's and don'ts. So in case if you are doing research, then first thing is always you have to focus on the research problem, and second thing is objectives. Don't just directly think about the statistical things. See, what researchers generally do is, see, we'll use advanced statistical techniques and our paper or our research work will become more and more healthier. It's not like that. According to the situation, if you have applied the test, then it will become more healthier. Your research paper or your research dissertation, whatever is there. So whenever you are doing research, first thing is you have to focus more about the research problem, whether it's realistic or not. If it is realistic, then only you'll be able to write conclusion in proper manner. And second thing is, every time when you use any statistical technique, check the suitability of the test. Don't just use the test for the sake of use. Okay. So whenever you are using any test, just check whether it's suitable on collected data or not. And again, see, if you have prepared questionnaire open-ended, then no any statistical test is applicable on open-ended type of data. So you can use both kind of data, both kind of statistical techniques, quantitative research analysis and qualitative research analysis. all the statistical tests are result of quantitative research, but you can go for qualitative research as well. So don't just use the test for the sake of use, but check the reliability, whether it's suitable or not suitable on collected data, which kind of test scale you have used to collect the data, that is also important. So research is a stepwise process. Don't just directly jump to the statistical test. Generally, researchers' aim is to use, you know, advanced, more and more advanced statistical techniques. It's not like that. From first word to last word, research is something which should be relevant, or we can say in a flow. It should be in a flow. Whatever you have considered in your objective, you have to check whether conclusion is actually whatever you have written is match, no, or actually the result of your objectives or not. That way you have to write the conclusion. That is what I can say about the research writing. And don't just follow your friends in research work. Not friends, but I can say colleagues. She has used or he has used this advanced technique and I will go for same technique in my research work, in my PhD dissertation. Don't do that. That is what I can say about. Yes, in one your class, can you explain in one question or various analysis for various questions? See, my few research works are under process for the publication, so I cannot share questionnaire with you, but Anant Education will definitely help you in the questionnaire preparing process. So we'll organize a webinar on scale development or questionnaire preparation, so you can attend that and you can get an idea about how to prepare the questionnaire, because it's a long list what to do and what not to do while preparing the questionnaire. So I cannot share questionnaire with you currently because my research work is under publication process. So I cannot share it with you right now, but we'll definitely organize one webinar where you will be able to check which kind of variables should be there, what kind of measures should be there to prepare the proper questionnaire. So that we'll definitely discuss in detail. Equal variances assume that means, see, if you have any idea about hypothesis testing, then in case of hypothesis, always null hypothesis is assumption and alternative is the thing or statement which researcher wants to prove. So equal variances, that means variances are equal for two populations. If you are comparing three populations, then variances are equal for three populations. Why we assume that variances are equal? Variances, that means how much they differ. Variable in particular sample, how much they differ with each other. So if variances are same, that means in one sample, suppose values are 5, 10 and 15. That means we can say difference is of 5 point. In second variable, if difference is very low or high compared to 5 point, then both the samples, to compare both the samples is not feasible. So variances should be equal. That means in first sample, if difference is of 5 points or 10 points, average difference between points are 5 or 10, between observations are 5 or 10, same should be in case of second population, same should be in third population. That is called equal variances. For which type of question, what kind of test can be applicable? So if one variable is under study, you can go for simple univariate test. Then if two variables are there, you can go for bivariate test. And if you have list of variables or several variables, you want to analyze several variables simultaneously, then you can go for multivariate test. Now list of tests are available under univariate, bivariate and multivariate. Which test is suitable, that depends on the situation. And again, that depends on the objectives of the research. when is it right to use the dendrogram, or we have to use it always while performing the test. See, basically dendrogram gives us idea about the number of factors extracted. Number of clusters formed, plus number of clusters formed. So it's very easy. You can check that using agglomeration schedule as well. So it's not compulsory, or we can say necessary, to every time go for the dendrogram. But you can, if you want to give more importance to your result, I can say, see, I told you earlier as well, in your research work, if 2 to 3 objectives are there, and for each and every objective you have used different statistical test, then importance of each test will be equal. But if you have used one particular test only, so 100% importance you have to give to that particular test, and you have to do in-depth study. That means you have to write, you know, each and every step, everything in detail for that particular test. So if you are using cluster analysis only, if you have used cluster analysis in your research work, you have not used anything else, and your objective is fully satisfied by that particular test, then you need to perform both the things, agglomeration schedule and dendrogram. But if 3 to 4 objectives are there and different tests you have used, then no need to write in detail. You can use agglomeration schedule. On the basis of that, you can write the interpretation, how many factors have been extracted. How many clusters have been formed. CFA will you handle in future, ma'am? Yes, definitely. We'll organize webinar on CFA, but again, it will take time. Minimum 2 hours we require to understand CFA. So we'll definitely contact the participants, those who have attended this webinar, EFA, because it will help you a lot. Yeah, sure. We'll post about the future webinars in this WhatsApp group. So if you are doing research, if you are associated with research, continue with this WhatsApp group. We'll definitely share the news about the future webinars. Thank you so much. Next, still we have a time. If you have any queries, you can ask me. And if you don't have any queries, then we can wind up the session. So I think no more questions are there. Ruchi ma'am. Hello.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. I think no more questions are there.
Okay, ma'am. We can end up the session.
Okay, one question I am able to see here in chat box. Give me a few minutes. In cluster analysis, we get a picture like scree plot. Is it possible, ma'am? I am not able to understand your question. See, scree plot, yes, you can get that, you choosing that option. In each and every test, graphical presentation is there. So software SPSS will help you to prepare graphical presentation. But again, if you have output tables, you can write the interpretation using output tables. Here in case of cluster analysis, we have dendrogram.
Hello.
Yes, yes. Yes, in case of cluster analysis, we have dendrogram. Yes. I think no more questions are there. Yes, ma'am.
We can wind up the session now, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Thank you very much, ma'am.